Political parties! Political parties are an example of a linkage institution. Linkage institutions connect the people to the government. Political parties are a group who tries to win elections so they can control the government. The political parties. How are they set up? Political parties are cut into three different slices, if you will. The governmental party is made up of office holders that influence policy, like Congress members or the president. The organizational party is the workers and activists that make up the formal party structure. People who actually work or volunteer for a political party. The party in the electorate is a weird sounding name for the voters that support the party's ideology. The people who actually care enough to get off the couch, drive to their local school, and vote. Political parties are like many other things that change or transform over time. A party realignment is when coalitions or voting blocs abandon their political party to join a different political party. These can be signaled by critical elections. A critical election describes an election which there is a dramatic change of a voter bloc's behavior. Like when black voters left the Republican Party to support FDR's Democratic Party because they liked things the New Deal was doing for their community. Now, a party de-alignment is when coalitions abandon their political party but do not join a new party. They're kind of like, you know, I tried the whole supporting a party thing, it wasn't for me. I don't think I'm going to jump into another relationship. I need some time to be by myself. Some people participate in split ticket voting. That's when a voter selects candidates from different political parties on the same ballot. Let's look at how political parties' control of these government institutions could play a factor. In a unified government, one political party controls the presidency and both houses of Congress. Generally speaking, it's going to be easier for a political party to get their platform turned into law if they control both Congress and the presidency. Even though it was a unified government, JFK only got 1/4 of his proposals through Congress. Not every party member feels the same way about every single topic. There are ideological wings or differences within that party. A divided government is when one party controls the presidency while the other party controls one or both houses of Congress. Now, yes, generally it's much harder for the political party's platform to get turned into law. Some political scientists point out that divided governments still pass legislation, but it does stop legislation that is far left or right on the political spectrum. They also say divided government stops costly legislation. Let's look at the party organization at the national level. There are national committees, the Democratic National Committee and the Republican National Committee, and they have the same goal, to raise money so they can win elections. The FEC allows $32,400 per individual donated to the committee per year. They spend the money on presidential campaigns, which starts off with a national convention every 4 years, where the delegates elect the presidential candidate and they write their party platform. And they also spend money on party building activities. Political parties have to break off into the state level, of course, where they kind of function on their own. They have to get on their state's ballots. They have to interact, go door to door at the state level. But the end goal is to have control of that national government. The DNC and the RNC are kind of like a nonprofit organization in that they have a corporate structure. The party chairperson or party chair is the leader of the national committee. All right, there you have it. Political parties, a very important role. You know, people don't always agree. And like in our country, we don't just kill them. We like debate it out and we vote for the person we want to represent us and make the decisions. It's not bad. Nice job, political parties.